The IHSAA football postseason is upon us, and MTC Sports will be there to catch the action.
It's win or go home. We'll have the big names, the big teams, as we bring you the biggest games of the postseason from our area.
Watch them all live on MTC Sports.
We'll be there October 31st, November 7th, 14th, and 21st as we follow the sectionals all the way to semi-state.
Tune in to mtcsports.net
or catch the replay on CN81.
See you at the game.
Hello, and thank you for tuning in to the Fox Sports Indiana Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports. We're so excited that you decided to join us tonight. We're here to talk high school football, and we are at the semi-state level championship night. What a great night it is for the IHSAA and for these teams that are now left in this tournament. Greg Mash here, Coach Sean Wines, leading the charge, getting you ready to go for tonight's broadcast for the Rensselaer Central Catholic game. We'll talk all about that game as this show progresses. But first, before we even get started, we want to talk about last week. MTC Sports was at the Monrovia at Shenandoah ball game, and it was a cold, blistery night, Coach. A great football game, and what a roller coaster it was. Tell us what you saw that night.
Well, luckily for me, I was sitting in the warmth of my home watching this thing on the great live video stream, but you guys did a great job. Hey, it was a great game. We had the wing tee, run some jet, run some power football on there, and then we had the double dive and the veer coming from Monrovia. I know Coach Hutchins has been there before. He's been to the semi-state. And so it was a really great game. I'm glad I got to enjoy a little hot cocoa, but you guys did a great job. It was a great ball game.
Yeah, it really was. We got to see two really quality running teams that night. Monrovia come in. They were leading the nation, according to Max Preps, in rushing, team rushing. They've got over 5,400 yards this year. Unbelievable number as a team. I mean, you're talking over 400 yards churning the ball. I mean, Woody Hayes would love this.
You know,
there's a lot of clouds of dust going on with that football team, but they come in and they did what they do, and that was to run the football. Third play from scrimmage, Trevor Ellis takes the ball to the house. It was a big moment for Monrovia, but right after that happened, Shenandoah really buckled it down. Their defense came alive, and it was a great thing to see. Cody Rudy, man, number 51 for Shenandoah. What a great night he had that night. What did you see from the big guy there in the middle?
Well, I tell you, he is a very, very physical player. Luckily for us, we got to see them a little bit in the Sheridan scout film when we played Sheridan. The guy gets all over the field. A big guy, he has great feet, very physical, very aggressive. And as you mentioned earlier, he's an emotional leader. He really gets excited, loves to play the ball game, and it gets his buddies pumped up.
Yeah, absolutely. And it was a joy to see. And we talk about that fourth quarter. I mean, it was 14-8 going into the end. Mm-hmm. You know, into that fourth quarter, and it was really when the excitement, the drama, you know, really came to life. And that, from us on the TV side, I mean, that's what we love to see is that drama. And so what happened, we saw fumbles. We saw back-to-back fumbles. Yes. We saw two interceptions. We saw fumbles go and be recovered by the team that fumbled. It was just this emotional roller coaster, and we loved every minute of it. You know, it was just a joy to do. And so Monrovia does, they end up scoring there in the fourth quarter, and a couple times, so they win and go on to semi-state, which is the point we're at now. And at semi-state, they get welcomed, you know, they get a welcome. Evansville Matter Day, the number one team ranked in the state. Talk to us a little bit about what you see in that matchup.
Well, Matter Day is going to be fast. They play a great schedule down there in the Evansville area, a lot of the bigger schools in their conference. But they've got to make that long trip. That is a long, leg-killing trip all the way up in the bus. I'm excited to see that one. Monrovia is going to be sound. They're going to do the same thing they do every time, pound it, pound it, pound it, pound it. And they're going to have to see if they can match up that speed with that physicality. It'll be an interesting clash of techniques and skills.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you talk about that point now. You Matter Day, I mean, you look at their schedule, and they do. They load up with some of the big boys that are down there, and they're not shy about playing them. And they've done really well this year. They're sitting at 13-0, number one in the state on the AP side. And it's really, I'm with you, it's going to be a very exciting matchup. And I'll be very interested to see if Monrovia can continue to grind out the ball like they have. You know, you look at their two losses this year, both times they've scored over 40 points. So it's not like they're being stopped necessarily, but the other team is just outscoring them. So it'll be very interesting to see what happens on that side of the bracket.
You see a lot of respect out there on the field right
definitely
now, too, amongst the two teams.
These two teams really just fought so hard tonight.
24-14, your score.
So, Coach, we're gonna go and start talking about this game that a lot of people have tuned in tonight to see, and this is the Central Catholic Knights here at the Rensselaer Central Bombers. This is a rematch Week 8, we got to see it on MTC Sports. It was a 9-0 defensive juggernaut. Lots of big plays on the defensive side of things. You got to take a look at that film. What did you see that night? Because it was full of drama. It was full of excitement, and we're anticipating that again tonight.
Oh, I'd absolutely say so. Defense, defense, defense. There were some big plays on the offensive game, but I'm telling you, both defenses can run the guys down. You know, Anther had a couple big runs. He got caught. You know, the Rensselaer kids took off. They got to be caught. So it's going to be a great defensive battle. I'm sure there will be some adjustments made. Some of the offenses will probably find a little bit more yardage here and there, but it's going to be definitely worth watching.
Yeah. You look at both these teams. I mean, they're ranked 1-2 in 2A as far as points allowed on defense. I mean, it's no surprise necessarily that it was that kind of game the last time. But you talk about adjustments that are made, especially this time of year. The coaches have watched a lot of film, and they've got a lot of ideas on what they're going to be doing. It'll be interesting to see if the offenses can't make those adjustments to do a little bit something more this week. Well, we're gonna talk about that game just a little bit more a little later in the show. But right now, we're going to go to a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to go to an interview we had with Coach Chris Meeks. You don't want to miss that. Stay tuned. We'll be right back here on the Fox Sports Indiana Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports.
Are you a fan of exciting action, great sporting atmosphere, and good displays of sportsmanship?
I am definitely a fan.
High school sports, pure spirit, pure sport, pure entertainment value. Are you a fan of amazing spirit, incredible drama, and affordable ticket prices?
I'm definitely a fan.
High school sports, pure spirit, pure sport, pure entertainment value.
Welcome back to the Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports, presented by Fox Sports Indiana. We're very excited that you decided to join us tonight, because tonight it's championship night at the semi-state level. Earlier today, I got to sit down with Coach Chris Meeks and interview him about his Rensselaer Central Bombers team. And more than that, it was about the community here in Rensselaer. And it was very, very exciting, very touching. It's very interesting to hear how this Rensselaer community really combines efforts. They join forces when you start talking Rensselaer football. They've been doing football for a very long time here at Rensselaer, had a lot of success over the years, but tonight they're trying to get to a place that they've never gone before, and that is to go to the state finals. So here's the interview with Coach Chris Meeks. We'll be back in just a moment after that.
Out of the football. It's a quarterback keeper all the way. They're trying to get around the edge. He's got some room. He makes it to the pylon, and he dances in. Touchdown, Dylan Wright.
I think we've gotten better week to week. If you look at week one, we gave up 34 points against a very good Kankakee Valley team. Since then, our defense really got dialed in, and we defend very well against the run. Teams like to test us in the passing game. Bremen quarterback last week was 19 for 41 passing, so I thought we did a great job against the pass. They threw some underneath stuff that they caught, but our kids rallied and kept it from being big plays. But our defense has been getting better and better. Our offense has been clicking, I think, on all cylinders all year, other than the Central Catholic game. But, you know, it's just a week-to-week getting better process. Mm-hmm. It's a core group of kids that when they were young in middle school, that you could just tell they were outstanding. The chemistry's great. You know, it's got a lot of athletes, a lot of speed, and there's speed all the way across the field. And I think that's huge. You know, we've had some big, strong guys, physical guys in the past, but this team's identity is its speed and athleticism. So, you know, you look at our offense, it starts with Rylan Arhood. He's rushed for over 1,800 yards, fast kid, very physical, reads defense as well. Dylan Wright at our quarterback, he's another athletic kid. One thing that people see is that he doesn't throw a whole lot. He's a very capable passer. You know, we just choose to run the ball a lot, mix in some play action passes, but when we choose to dial up a pass, he's very effective there. Mm-hmm. We've got some excellent receivers in Ab Kiger, Austin Fleming. Both those guys are excellent when we go to the passing game. Dalton Souders as well. And then defensively, you know, like I said, we're very fast defense. We get after it, very aggressive. Our defensive line has been playing great all year, but You know, Ab Kiger at the safety position, he's a kid that's going to play at the college level. You know, he leads our defense, makes sure that the kids are in the right place and so on. And, you know, we have a lot of very effective leaders and great players out there on defense.
Mm-hmm. The handoff to Anthrop again. Around the outside, and he is stalked by
that's
Ab Kiger
15,
again.
15, Ab Kiger.
Yeah, Ab tore his ACL in eighth grade. And then he tore his ACL again in June last year, going into the summer, early in the summer. And so we thought we were going to be without him. It was his same leg, second ACL tear, and he ended up, rehabbing and doing all the things he needed to do. Yeah. And, you know, we were able to get him back out on the field week four against Tipton. Granted, he was nowhere close to 100%, but his leadership was huge for us.
Yeah.
And by the end of the year, you know, I would say he was about 75 to 80%, you know, but still it was the leadership that we needed on the field. At this point, Ab's 100%, and when you watch his highlight clips, he's extremely fast, athletic, and making the plays that he needs. The thing with him is he reads offenses so well. He can come up and attack, like you said, on the run, but he's also a kid that can go up and get the ball. And he's got a great vertical leap. And, you know, we like it when teams throw deep on us because it gives us an opportunity to pick the ball up.
Again, shotgun. They got four wide receivers split out. Anthony just stays in the block. Denard steps up in the pocket. Souders. Nope. That's Fleming. I'm sorry. And he's going to let him know.
Well, they bring speed and athleticism from the end position. And our motto is the best defense against the pass is the rush. Mm-hmm. So we can bring those guys from the outside, but also, too, both guys we can drop back in coverage. So we can give the look that they're coming, but then drop them back in the flats. It also, too, by teams defending the edge so much because of those two guys, it opens up things in the middle for the blitz, like Trevor Hill blitzing through the middle and getting the safety. Yeah. So it opens up a lot of things for our defense. Mm-hmm. So what we're finding is a lot of teams will double-team those guys. But our defensive coordinator is pretty sharp, and he'll make adjustments accordingly to that.
Long third down play. They fake a couple times. Drop back to pass again, going over the top. Wide open receiver. It's Steinke. And he's streaking down the sideline. Going to be tackled out of bounds at about the 24-yard line.
He's fired up on that play.
It's exciting. We've played football here since 1898. Never have been to a state championship. The whole town is behind us 100%. We have a motto, you know, we're 6,000 strong, and that's how many people live in Rensselaer, and we feel like everywhere we go, they're right there behind us. Well, the first two semi-states we went to Fort Wayne Bishop Lures, which, that's tough in itself with all their D1 athletes and so on. So we couldn't get over the hump there. And then last year we went down to Tipton. We thought we had an opportunity there, but with all the young kids that we had, you know, we kind of had the deer in the headlight look and got beat 27-0. But after that game, we made a commitment to get back to the semi-state game and put ourselves in position for another opportunity to get to Indianapolis. And thank God it's here at Rensselaer. We're excited about that. It'll be our first semi-state that we've hosted. Our whole community is excited about it. They will be here, and hopefully we can get it done tonight. Oh, it's awesome, and our kids feed off of it. You know, it is a true 12th man, and it's a small community, but they back their football team. And one of the traditions we started last year was when we win a championship on the road, we immediately, you know, we have the fire trucks and all that like most small communities do, but we pull right up on Main Street, and we shut down right there and unload the buses, and we call them bomber jacks, but we circle around the courthouse and do bomber jacks with our community celebrating the victory.
That's great.
And I'll tell you, if we win the semi-state game tonight, there'll be one heck of a victory celebration at our courthouse square. Yeah, we consider ourselves a blue-collar community, a community that works hard, and that's how these kids practice and work in the summer. I mean, we live in the weight room. We go to camps. you know, we do all the things that, I feel like we need to, do to be successful. I've had a coaching staff that's been with me for, 16 years. You know, we don't have turnover in coaching staff. We're all on the same page. We all believe in the same thing, and that's working hard, you know, trying to, get the best that we can be and, you know, let the chips fall. But more times than not, if our kids go out there and play the best of their abilities, we're going to win football games, and that's what we've done here the past several years.
Fourth down. Feeling like this is just as good as a punt from here. He's going to be sacked. Ball's loose. 71's going to fall on it, but they'll lose yardage again, and Rensselaer Central makes a stand.
It all comes down to this. Fox Sports Indiana presents the 2014 IHSAA Football Championships. Watch every play from all six championship games live Thanksgiving weekend on Fox Sports Indiana Plus. Brought to you by Indiana Members Credit Union.
You're watching the Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports. Thank you so much for joining us and, making us a part of your Friday night. We're so excited to be bringing you Semi-State Championship Football here at Rensselaer Central High School. And Coach, we're going to do a little bit of analysis here. We got you on the hot seat right now. We're going to be talking about the X's and O's a little bit. You know, this is a, game that a lot of people have circled on their calendar saying, this is what I want to watch. And, there's a good reason for that. We've got two high-powered offenses, but we got two shut-down defenses just on this collision course that's, that is going to happen tonight right in front of us. So, Coach, you've seen the film. You've seen some of the games on both sides of the field. What is it that impresses you about each of these teams?
Well, for both teams, it's speed, speed, speed. Both teams have a great wealth of speed in the, skilled players. Rensselaer has a little bit smaller defensive front, but they're quick as well, very well coached. And, you know, Central Catholic has a nice big offensive front. So that's going to be an interesting contrast between the quickness and speed of the defensive front of Rensselaer and the size of, Lafayette Central Catholic. Both skilled guys are washes on both teams. You've got the Anthrop factor for Central Catholic, which is going to be a big issue. So you have to keep track of him. They like to move him around, try to make him and get in a position to make some big plays in open field. And then, you know, you have the pound it, pound it, pound it physical mentality of the Rensselaer's single wing offense. So it's a great contrast, a lot of neat things, a lot of similarities between the two teams, and obviously they're both well coached. So all those things together are going to make this the beginning. Everyone should have circled, like you said, and it's for a good reason.
Yeah. Well, you look at what happened last time, and it was a 9-0 shutout by Rensselaer. I mean, that doesn't happen very often. In fact, the last time that happened for Central Catholic, 2004, 10 years ago, was the last time that they lost to a shutout. So you think about that, and you think about the statistics that Rensselaer puts up on the defensive side of the ball. I mean, they've got over 130 tackles for losses for the season. You talk about the number of sacks, the number of interceptions, even five safeties as a team. I mean, that's just, you don't hear that very often. I mean, they're so fast to the football. Tell us, I mean, do they have what it takes to shut this high-powered offense of Central Catholic down one more time?
Well, you can't say never, but I'm telling you, I think it would be very difficult, especially with the time that, you know, they've had to look at the film, analyze a few of the things, hopefully for them, find a few places they can attack. But I would definitely throw the opportunity out of the door, but I think it would be very difficult, especially with the, talent and, the speed that, Lafayette Central Catholic has.
Yeah. Well, let's do a little true-false here if we can. We'll have a little fun with this, put you on the seat here. But if we say true or false, and you look in the backfield, I mean, both backfields, we have two of the best running backs in the area. I mean,
absolutely.
Between Arhood and Anthrop, I mean, they're putting up 1,800 yards this year. I mean, you look at the touchdown score, they're just crazy. I think it's 28 for Jackson. Ryland had like 37, something like that. So, I mean, they not only run the ball well, but they finish well. You know, they get the ball in the end zone. But if I say true or false, one of these running backs is going to get 100 yards tonight, what do you say?
True.
True.
True. I don't think he can stop either one of them. Not for less than 100, no way.
So you're going to say both running backs?
I think it's very possible. I think it's going to be bruised and battered, and they've got some blood on their clothes. But I'm telling you, they both have the ability, especially with the fronts that they have. They both play a nice team game, so I think it's definitely possible.
Okay. True or false, it took until the fourth quarter of that game in week 8 before there was a touchdown scored. Does this week, does it take until the fourth quarter before that first touchdown is scored?
I would say false. I think someone is going to figure something out early. Get a big play here or there, whether it be someone stumbling and falling down or some kind of fluke play, or, you know, maybe someone can march it down. It's just going to be difficult for me to imagine that they can go a full half with those skilled kids that they have, those athletes, and not have a score this time.
Mm-hmm. Well, true or false, we'll go this route. The defense is going to make more plays than the offense to win this football game.
That's a good one. I would say probably true. Both defenses are absolutely fantastic. I think we're going to see more plays for loss, but it's only going to take, you know, two or three plays on the offensive side of the ball. I think, you know, two or three scores might be enough to decide it. So it's the long term doing your job every single time that's going to matter, because it's going to take just a couple plays. So I agree with that.
Yeah, yeah. You look at this time of the year, every play is amplified, every mistake amplified even more. So it's going to be very interesting to see. Because you've got the Rensselaer's Bombers, they are an experienced bunch. They're senior laden, but they've been to the semi-state before. They were here at this point last year. It was one of those times, and even talking with Coach Meeks this week, it was like they were excited to be there. But that was kind of where, I mean, that's where they were. They were just excited to be there. So it caused maybe a little more anxiety than what they were used to playing with. And it didn't bode well for them, whereas they were defeated by Tipton last year. They avenged that loss this year against Tipton. But then they also, now they're back in familiar territory. And you look on the other side, Central Catholic, they've won four state titles in a row at the Class A level. Last year they bump up to Class 2A, and they were bounced in the second round of sectionals. So they spent a whole winter in a place where, or early winter, they were used to playing football, and they did not get a chance to do it. So, but those teams, those kids that are now juniors, you talk about the Anthrops, the Kronks, Corcorans, that bunch, the few six levels, those guys, they were all freshmen that last time they were at the state championship. So do you feel like there's maybe a little bit of difference there, where you've got a squad that's been there as early as last year, but the time that Central Catholic kids were there, they were freshmen. Is that going to play into this, you think?
Well, I'm sure. Both of them are coming in with a little chip. Both of them feel that they were really disappointed with the way they finished last year, especially Rensselaer. You know, Rensselaer, they played a real good Tipton ball club, and that wasn't a fluke. I mean, Rensselaer deserved to be there. Tipton deserved to be there, and it was a battle. So those kids are definitely focused. And the fact that they're seniors, the fact that they've been through there and this is their last chance, I think they'll probably have a little bit more focus because the other kids know they're going to be back. Now, obviously, those guys are well coached at Central Catholic. They're disciplined. They know exactly what's going to take to win because they've been there. They've seen what the seniors had to do when they were freshmen. But I'm kind of with what you're kind of thinking, that Rensselaer's experience and that deeper desire, that more time being spent, is going to come through in the end.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Well, we're going to go to a quick break. We will be right back with some more analysis about this game. We're going to get our picks coming. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss it. You're watching the Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports, presented by Fox Sports Indiana.
So they hand off.
There he goes.
He's got a hole. Touchdown.
Oh,
there
we
with
go.
The steal. Run out.
Throw down to second base. Tag applied.
Payoff pick.
He finds Richardson.
Strike three call.
It's good if it goes.
On and over, side. People still got it.
Count it.
Welcome back. We're wrapping things up here on the Fox Sports Indiana Semi-State Preview Show here on MTC Sports. Coach Sean Wines, Greg Mash here. We're talking Central Catholic Rensselaer. We got a few more things we want to discuss before we get into our picks, so stay tuned for that. But, Coach, we're talking about these kids, Central Catholic Rensselaer. We got a lot of big names, a lot of guys that we've heard about for a while, you know, through the years playing football in this area. Let's talk about them just a little bit. You look at the offensive side of Rensselaer, and they are a juggernaut. They have scored 55 points a game this year. And that's not, you don't just do that by accident. That is just quality kids doing their jobs and getting the results from it. Let's talk about them a little bit, can we?
Well, it starts out with the Arhood kid. I mean, great running back. He has right now 1,800 yards. And the quarterback is 1,400 yards. So when you focus on the running back, the Arhood kid, they get the nice passes over the top. Another kid that doesn't get as much mention as some of the other guys is the Fleming boy, number 88. He's one of the running backs. He has a lot, very involved in the passing game out of the backfield. He's a good lead blocker on the offensive side. And then, you know, we'll talk about him later, but he's also a solid player on the defensive side of the ball. So those three guys really kind of run that offense with a lot of contributions by other players. But in that front is physical, it's quick, it's aggressive, and they've blocked to the whistle.
Yeah, and one of the things that impresses me the most about that offense is it's so compact. I mean, and it's all about misdirection. Mm-hmm. And you get caught. I remember in week 8 when we filmed that game, there were so many times when our camera guys were even a little stumped trying to figure out where that ball was. They do a great job of hiding the ball, and it shows. I saw a clip from the game against Wheeler in the sectional championship game where Fleming was the guy who had the ball. And he literally ran by two or three guys. I'm sorry, it's West Lafayette. Mm-hmm. Two or three guys, and they just bumped him because they didn't even know he had the football. And it just goes on to a great run, and it was very exciting. But those are the things I think that can make worlds of difference, especially now, again, when everything is amplified and done. We're gonna talk about the Central Catholic team here a little bit on the offensive side as well. You look at their offense, and it really centers around Jackson Anthrop. I mean, that's no new news to anybody. He is a quality running back. What we've enjoyed to see from MTC Sports side is how he has matured in that position over the past few years. I mean, he was used a little more out on the wing and the wideout, you know, last year with Smith still in the backfield. But now this is his time to shine at that back position, the tailback position. And he's done an exceptional job this year. He's run the ball very hard. We're seeing him lower his shoulder a little bit more, you know, initiating the contact at times. And that's a big deal as a running back, as you mature into that role. And it really benefits you in quarter two, quarter three, and you're still lowering your shoulder in quarter four. That's when, you know, the other side, maybe the legs are getting a little more tired, so you're breaking a little more tackles. But Jackson's done a great job. He's rushed for 1,800 yards himself. He's got 28 touchdowns on the ground. You look at Avery Denhart from the quarterback position. I mean, this is a young man who has matured over the course of this season. He's just a sophomore, but playing now almost like a senior. I mean, his statistics, he's 129 to 215. He's got 24 touchdowns, only 4 interceptions. So this is a young man who is putting the ball where he needs to put it, not committing many mistakes, and it's really benefited the Central Catholic Knights. And he spreads it across, you know, Luke Fuchsik. He's had a couple big games this year. He's got 781 yards receiving, 9 touchdowns. Jackson gets the ball out of the backfield as well. And then now we kind of transition, if we can, to the defensive side, because both of these teams, you mentioned it before, both of these teams are loaded on defense. Let's talk about Rensselaer and especially those defensive ends.
Well, just like baseball, you want to have a strong middle in football. And they really do. They have two nice, big, strong defensive tackles. John Aulnes is the leader there. He has 65 tackles on the year. He has 17 tackles for loss from that position. So getting off of blocks, moving quick. And then you have the two middle linebackers, Sam Ayler. He is leading the team with tackles with 98. He has 17 tackles for loss and 3 sacks. And Dalton Murphy is his mate inside there, the senior. He has 77 tackles. But some guys who are going to be a big impact this week, especially if they end up having to throw the ball a little bit and the contain players of the defensive ends. You've got Dalton Salter and Austin Fleming. Both of those guys have had great years. Both of those are well over 25 tackles for loss for this season. Fleming has 12 sacks. Souter has 9 sacks. Souter's the one with the cast. Yeah. That's kind of slowed him down a little bit. But those guys putting pressure on the quarterback, containing the ball inside to those middle linebackers, to that interior line, if they can handle that, that's going to really make a lot of easy work or better work for them, so that now they can just pass rush. Mm-hmm. And they'll put the pressure on the younger quarterback. So those guys, that's the key to their defense, and then speed in the backfield to run guys down.
Well, we look at the other side of the ball and you start talking about Central Catholic and their defense. I mean, it starts up the middle with Coy Cronk. He is a big young man. We've seen him over the past few years at Central Catholic Sports, and he has improved tremendously in that middle linebacker position. He is just he's a train wreck. I mean, reckless abandon going for the football, and you love that. I mean, he's like 6'4", 250 pounds, something like that. I mean, he's just a big young man, and he delivers a pop, you know, when he goes after that football. But right next to him is Joe Corcoran, his brother Ross, you know, is a multi-time state champ. From that position as well at Central Catholic, but now it's Joe's turn, and Joe is playing very well. We've seen him 3 times this year, and he has really impressed us from that middle linebacker position, just making tackles. He's just one of those kids that's always around the football. It's nothing too flashy or anything like that. He's just rock solid, making tackles, and that's what they do. You look at Grant Vogt, you know, they're from the defensive end position, 6.5 sacks. You know, he's got 43 tackles, but he is really a disruptor. I mean, that's one thing that we've seen from our perspective, is he's very much disrupting the other team's offense and really holding on to blocks and just letting those linebackers peel around to make those tackles like they do. You know, Central Catholic's defense, it's number two in the state total with 7 points a game, number one in 2A. But the interesting thing is it's not real flashy. You know, the statistics don't really show, like, you know, the wow numbers, maybe like Rensselaer does, but they are so solid, and they just get the job done, play in and play out. And at this time of the year, we say, you know, offense is what puts people in the stands. It's defense that wins championships. And you've got two quality defenses that are here tonight ready to go at it. And it's going to be so interesting to see what happens on the gridiron. So, Coach, we've really dissected some things down. We've broken down as best we can from our humble perspective. But now we got to start talking about our picks. Because, like it or not, from our seat, this is the great thing that we do as the media, is we get to tell you who we think is going to who's going to win tonight. But first, we're going to make you Rensselaer and CC fans hold on just a little bit, because we're going to talk Monrovia and Evansville Matter Day on the other side of the bracket. So, Coach, Matter Day comes to Monrovia. It's a Saturday afternoon game. Who do you see coming out on top?
Boy, I tell you what, it's going to be a great one. Two things that probably puts me more toward Monrovia in this. One is the trip. That is a long trip, and there's definitely going to be a little bit leg dead. And the experience of Frontiers Coach Hutchins. Been there before. He's been to the state championship game. And I think he has a pattern for how to prepare his boys. So I'm going to put my nod to Monrovia by probably, well, at least a touchdown.
All right. Greg is going to talk about right now Matter Day and their program. They are a perennial state contender. They just year in and year out produce good quality squads. And you saw it last year. You know, they were bumped a little early last year, but the previous 2 years they were semi-state finalists. This year they're hungry again. They're back. They're sitting at 13-0, number one in the state at the Class 2A level. However, I'm going to go with the Monrovia Bulldogs, because if we have seen them this year, we've seen the way that they can run the football. They are coming to Monrovia. It is going to be a very cold afternoon, and it could be rainy a little bit. But with all that in consideration, I think Monrovia comes out on top. They're going to get Coach Hutchins back into the state title game. I think it's going to be my humble pick, 28-21, Monrovia. They go to the state finals. Now, Central Catholic, Rensselaer, the game you have tuned in to watch tonight, we are going to talk about that one, because we've dissected it. We've kind of looked at it from all different angles, offense, defense. We've got rankings. We've got statistics. We've got all that. Now we throw it all out the window. Who do you see winning this one, Coach?
Boy, I tell you, it's a coin flip, man. It's going to all come down to turnovers. I really think that the drive and the passion of those seniors, and at the end of the day, you've got to count on your seniors. So I'm going to think that Rensselaer is probably going to be able to pull out the one or two extra plays that is going to be required to win this game. So I'm going to give Rensselaer in a tight one.
So now everybody's looking at me, right?
That's
so,
right.
So this is a very interesting game to me. We saw what happened in week 8, and I think that we're going to see a very similar game on the defensive side. I think there's going to be a lot of three and outs or punts or just maybe drives and then they stall and just, you know, fourth down trying to convert and they're not going to be able to convert. And it's just one of those things where it's going to grind and grind. I think as the second half opens, as it begins to open up a little bit and we see a little more spread out, maybe a little more scoring. I don't think it's going to be a 9-0. I think we're going to see 24-21 is going to be my pick. Who's going to win? I think this is the year that Rensselaer finally gets it done. They go to the state finals. Coach Meeks gets to take his team, that senior-laden group. They're going to go, and I believe that they will win this year the state tournament. CC fans, we mean no disrespect. You have a quality program. I just think that this is the year that Rensselaer gets it done, and we'll see that. You know, that's why they play the game, right? That's what the great Chris Berman always says. That's why they play the game. So we're going to go to that now. We're closing the preview show here now, so stay tuned. We're going to go to the field. We're going to cut to our guys there in the booth. You've been watching the Fox Sports Indiana semi-state preview show here on MTC Sports. Stay tuned. You're going to see the game right now. It's coming up next. Don't move the muscle.